Merhaba, hoş geldiniz. Hello everyone and welcome to our Turkish lesson. In this video, we will learn the definition of a verb, verb conjugation, the names of tenses, and related suffixes mek, mag with clear examples. What is a verb? Fiil nedir? A verb describes an action, occurrence, or a state of being. Fiil, bir iş, oluş ve hareketi bildiren kelimelere fiil denir. Verbs have tenses. Fiillerin zamanları vardır. There are three primary tenses. These are present tense, past tense, and future tense. Present tense, geniş zaman. Geniş zaman. Past tense, geçmiş zaman. Geçmiş zaman. Future tense, gelecek zaman. Gelecek zaman. Mek and mag. These are suffixes in Turkish. It's called mastar eki. Mek, mag. It's easy to know which one to use. Mek or mag. Let's see how. When a verb is with one of these vowel letters, a, ı, o, u, then it takes mag. For example, almak, almak, to take. When a verb is with one of these vowel letters, e, i, ö, ü, then it takes mek. For example, gülmek, gülmek, to laugh. Fiiller, verbs. Yıkamak, to wash. Yıkamak, yıka, wash. Yıkamak. As you see, the suffix mak is here. Yıkamak. Yıka, wash. Yıkamak, to wash. Ben ellerimi yıkadım. I washed my hands. Yıkadım. Fiil çekimleri. Verb conjugation. Dear friends, if you haven't watched the previous video about the verb conjugation, please go back and watch it. The link is available in the description below. Yıka is verb. De represent tense. In this case, it is past tense. Yıka de. M represents the person, the first person. I, personal pronoun. Yıkadım. So this is the three in one. The verb, the tense, and the person. Ben ellerimi yıkadım. Or I can say ellerimi yıkadım. Here you can as well get rid of the pronoun ben or include it in the sentence. Moreover, the meaning does not change. Ellerimi yıkadım. I washed my hands. Ben ellerimi yıkadım. Geçmiş zaman. Past tense. I washed my hands. Ben ellerimi yıkıyorum. Şimdiki zaman. Present continuous tense. I am washing my hands. Ben ellerimi yıkıyorum. Ben ellerimi yıkayacağım. Gelecek zaman. Future tense. I will wash my hands. Ben ellerimi yıkayacağım. Next verb is yürümek. To walk. Yürümek. Ben yürüdüm. I walked. Ben yürüdüm. Ben yürüyorum. I am walking. Ben yürüyorum. Ben yürüyeceğim. I will walk. Ben yürüyeceğim. Next verb is konuşmak. To speak or to talk. Konuşmak. O Türkçe konuştu. She spoke Turkish. O Türkçe konuştu. O Türkçe konuşuyor. She is speaking Turkish. O Türkçe konuşuyor. O Türkçe konuşacak. She will speak Turkish. O Türkçe konuşacak. As we write sentences from left to right, dear friends, when you are translating Turkish to any other languages, you need to begin translating from right to left. This is because the word which has the essential information three in one word, like person, tense, and verb itself, is located at the end. Next verb is içmek, to drink. İçmek. Sen süt içtin. You drank milk. Sen süt içtin. Sen süt içiyorsun. You are drinking milk. Sen süt içiyorsun. Sen süt içeceksin. You will drink milk. Sen süt içeceksin. Next verb is yemek. To eat. Yemek. Here it might confuse between the verb and the noun because both to eat and food mean yemek. How will you differentiate the two? Now let's see. Yemek, to eat. Remember the verb conjugation, here it applies. Yemek, ye is the verb fiil. Mek is the suffix. It's master eki. Yemek, to eat. For example, yemek hazır mı? So here the meaning has changed. The previous example, yemek was a verb. Here it's a noun. Is food ready? Yemek hazır mı? Now let's see more examples. Kek yediniz mi? Did you eat cake? Kek yediniz mi? Kek yiyor musunuz? Are you eating cake? Kek yiyor musunuz? Kek yiyecek misiniz? Will you eat cake? Kek yiyecek misiniz? Next verb is yüzmek. To swim. Yüzmek. O yüzer. He swims. O yüzer. O yüzüyor. He is swimming. O yüzüyor. O yüzecek. He will swim. O yüzecek. Next verb is okumak. To read. Okumak. Kitap okudum. I read a book. Kitap okudum. Kitap okuyorum. I am reading a book. Kitap okuyorum. Kitap okuyacağım. I will read a book. Kitap okuyacağım. Dear friends, now you have learned the definition of a verb, the names of tenses, suffixes mek, mak, and the verb conjugation in Turkish with clear examples. Turkish verbs to be continued in the coming lessons. I really appreciate your time. Please feel free to write your comments. If you like our lesson, do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel for more useful lessons. Thank you for watching. İzlediğiniz için teşekkür ederiz. Kendinize iyi bakın. Hoşça kalın.